Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to install PostgreSQL in your Windows 10 operating system. In my previous video, I have shown you how to install Eclipse IDE in your Windows 10 operating system, and now I'll be showing you how to install PostgreSQL. Now, Eclipse is a very popular IDE, especially for the Java developers. And if you want to do some advanced Java stuff, that is to connect database system with your Java program, so in that case you need to have a very good relational database system. For that we are going to install this PostgreSQL. Now to install PostgreSQL, you need to first download it. Now to download, just click on a browser and then type PostgreSQL download for Windows. Yeah, now just click on enter, and now in here the first search result is from this postgresql.org. So now just click on that, and now here the latest version is PostgreSQL version 13, so we'll download this version 13. So for that I will click on download the installer. Yeah. Now here, as you can see, for Windows 64-bit, this 13.1 version is available to download. So just click on that. Yeah. And now your download will start automatically. Now I have already downloaded this PostgreSQL 13.1 version. So I'll just cancel this and I'll just open my download section, and here this is my downloaded PostgreSQL file. So I'll just double click on that and I will minimize this. Yeah, so now just accept it, and now here this is the installation directory. Now here this program files PostgreSQL/13. In this directory, this PostgreSQL is going to be installed. So I will just click on next. If you want to change your directory, then just click on that icon, that is this browse button, and you can change your destination. I don't want to change my destination, my installation destination, so I'll just keep it default and I'll just simply click on next. And now here basically there are these four components, that is this PostgreSQL server, then pgAdmin 4, stack builder, and then command line tools are going to be installed. So I'll just simply click on next, and now this is the data directory for which I will keep it default. If you want to change, then just simply click on that browse button and you can change your destination. I will keep it default and I'll just simply click on next. And now here you need to set your password. Now this is very important, you need to also remember this password for future use. So just type here your password. I'm typing my own and I'll just retype it, and now I'll just simply click on next. Now this is the port number, that is this 5432. I'll just keep it default, and now I will just keep it default and just click on next. And so these are the things that are going to be installed, so just click on next. Now here it says the setup is now ready to begin installation PostgreSQL on your computer, so just simply click on next, and there you go. So the installation has been started. It will take some time, a minute or two maybe. So I'll just speed this up and I will come back once it's done. So guys, as you can see now it's done. So I will just simply untick that, because now I'm going to download my pgAdmin 4. So that's also very important, because that thing will give you a Graphic User Interface, that is this GUI. So it will help you to give a very good interface, and you can write your SQL query over there. Otherwise, if you want to use your terminal, then also you can use that.
But for that, because if you are a beginner, if you are starting as a fresh, so for that I'll recommend you to use a GUI. And now we'll again open our browser, and now in here we'll type pgAdmin for download for Windows. Yeah, now just click on enter, and now here the first search result is from this pgadmin.org. That is this pgAdmin 4 for Windows. So just simply click on that. And now here the latest version is released on December 10, 2020. And the version name is pgAdmin 4 version 4.4.29. So just simply click on that. Yeah. And now in here there is basically two options. That is this 64exe and 86exe. So for that, if I have a 64-bit operating system, so I would simply click on this 64exe, and as you can see the download has been started, but I have already downloaded this file, so I'll just simply click on cancel, and I'll just open my download folder. So here as you can see, I have already downloaded this pgAdmin 4.29 version. So I'll just simply double click on that, and I'll just minimize it, and here just simply click on next, and this is the terms and conditions, that is basically this license agreement. So just I will just simply accept the agreement, and I'll just click on next. And in here installation folder, so for which I would like to keep it default, just click on next. Now here I will keep this all default, and just simply click on next. And so this is the destination where your pgAdmin 4 going to be installed, so I'll just simply click on install, and there you go. So the pgAdmin 4 installation has been started, so it will take some time, a minute or two maybe, so I'll just speed this up, and I will come back once it's done. So now that this pgAdmin 4 setup has been done, so I'll just simply click on this launch pgAdmin 4 and click on finish, and there you go, the pgAdmin 4 has been launched. So it will open your browser, and here you need to give that password that you have set during installation of PostgreSQL. So I'll just simply type that password, and then click on OK, and here now you are right into this pgAdmin GUI. So just simply click on this drop down option, that is the server, and here also you need to again give your password. So just give the password and click on save password, so that you don't need to type password every now and then. So now your dashboard has been launched. So here there is basically this Postgres database has already been given by default. I would like to create a new database, so for that I'll just simply click on database first, and then just click on right click, and then create database. Yeah, so here just type a database name. So I'll type my first DB, and if you go to this SQL option, so this is basically the syntax, that is this create database my first DB. This is the name of our database with owner, and owner name is Postgres, and encode is UTF-8. So I'll just then simply click on this general, and so now click on save. Yeah. Now see, my first DB has been created rightly. So basically now we have two databases, one is from Postgres, another is just now we have created my first DB. So here just go to schemas, and now here you can create a new table. Now we'll click on my first DB. That is the name of our database. Then we'll just simply right click on it, and here we'll write a script to create our table. Okay, so for that I will just simply click on create script, and this will open you a page where you can write your script, SQL script. So I'll just so for that I will type create table. My first table, that is the name of our table, my first table, and here we are going to give three columns. So I'll type my first column name, that is this person ID, and its data type is int. Then I will give full name, and I will give it a data type varchar with 255 characters. And then the third column I will give address, yeah, and its data type will be same varchar, and it's 255, yeah. So just select this and click on the run button, and so now you need to refresh, yeah, and there we go. And there we go, under this table, your first table, that is this my first table, has been rightly created, and these are the three columns, that is this person ID, full name and address. So this is how you create table in PostgreSQL. Now I'll just to visualize my table. So for that I will just simply type select star from my first table, yeah, semicolon. So just click on that and click on the run button, and here you get to see your table in the data output section. Person ID, full name and address, these are the three columns, and your name of the table is my first table. So this is how you download PostgreSQL and pgAdmin 4 for your graphic user interface. So that's all for this video. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and also please share with your friend, and please don't forget to subscribe our channel. It will help our channel to grow, and I am looking forward to make more of some videos on how to connect your Java program with your with PostgreSQL. So for that I will be coming up with new course on JDBC. So for that, just stay tuned on my channel, and don't forget to click on the subscribe button, and also press the bell button so that you get notified once we upload our videos on my channel. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.